This was Jesus speaking. This is not Peter and John. Please continue. God bless you. The two just things which are not convenient. Because God has given us such mind. Continue.
If you want to miss heaven, it's very easy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Things you must avoid if you want to make heaven.
Everywhere possible,
money. If you want to make heaven,
remove
your mind from money.
Stop
chasing money like it's your heaven. Ritual is money. Prostitute money. You may not be the one to win it. Maybe your children. You are one of them. You have the same share in heaven. And the dress money. And many parents will say, I don't know what my child is doing. I don't know what my son is doing. You are a liar before God. You that gave birth to your son, your daughter. You know that. You know that. You know that God is watching. On Judgment Day, you speak to. Number two,
media.
If you want to make heaven, avoid media, social media. Not everything you see here that is truth. Stop believing all they say. Before election, they have already ring it in the media. Bring somebody and destroy the person's life. Number three, church religions. Church religions. If you want to make heaven, avoid church religions. This is what my pastor said. This is what my church said. Whatever if your pastor said and your church said is not what God said. Avoid church religions. And get into personal relationship with God. Number four, change your routine. Change it. You will be doing something that is wrongful. And that will lead you has not called me.
Changes.
Number five. Stop desiring blessing more than God. Stop desiring God blessing more than God. If you want to make heaven, you must stop that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number five.
All different.
You must avoid pastors. Pastors. You have pastors. You have pastors. Is there any other pastor better than your pastor? Is there any other pastor that is anointed more than your pastor? There are people
much
pastors in their life. Even with different messages. They are confused. They are confused. And God has given you a pastor. For you to know what I'm saying, don't read the book of Jeremiah. Chapter 3. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jeremiah chapter 3. If anybody can read verse 15. Is anybody there? He said, I will give you pastor according to God's heart. Not all pastors are your pastors.
Some
are looking for pastors. You already have pastors. Too much of pastor will make you confused. Because the pastors we have in this generation, they are no longer saying one thing again. This one said it, this one said it, this one said it. Sometimes we get confused. Are you sure we are serving one God? Avoid it. Not all your pastors. Not all pastors are your pastors.
All your pastors are your pastors.
And number six.
I'll say hi.
If you want to make heaven,
well, when I go,
avoid self.
You're possibly
myself.
Amen.
Ourselves.
My
family.
Yes, our family.
Hallelujah.
My name.
Avoid if you want to make heaven.
You're possibly to hold on our go.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That can be taken from the book of Romans chapter 6 verse 11. Amen. Romans 7, 15, 4 to 21. Psalm 133, 23 to 24. I'm just giving the scripture reference. And the Bible tells us, hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
And I want to say this is the last thing.
Melton, I'm happy to tell you.
God does not send people to hell.
Oh, so no, that all your own never fall back with, right?
But he will know their choices. God does not send people to hell. You only know your choice. In Galatians chapter 6 verse 7. The Bible says, whatsoever a man sow, whatsoever a man desire, whatsoever a man choose, shall you find a
reap.
Can I ask you a question? Amen.
Amen.
What are you sowing?
If you are wearing a corner,
because whatever you sow now, you will reap it tomorrow. See, let me tell you, don't be deceived. Many will tell you, if you commit sin now, God will forgive you. I preach a message that looks stupid, and it was reality. I said, God is no longer interested. He's no longer interested in confession alone. Many of us are deceiving ourselves. God is in the business. God is in the business. When you confess, you forsake. When you confess, you must still make heaven. When you make heaven, you don't forsake. When you don't forsake.
And then,
that is why God is in the business
You confess your sin. You forsake your sin. You can confess your sin today. And you cry to me, go to hell. Today you see just that today. When you look at it, maybe you just come and you confess your sin. As you get old, you die. You can still make hair. Why? Because you are not ready to forsake them. The Bible says.